Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best of Slot, and today we're back playing Minecraft Dinosaurs, and we're gonna start in the mines. I have been busy. I've burnt through 4 iron pickaxes in my little mining journey, a little bit more of the diamond, but not much, just to get a little bit of bedrock, and I just want to show you guys where we are. I've put like a little, basically this is, where are we? There we are, this is how far we've come, but I started over here. I've been in the mines for about 2 hours at this point in time, sort of burning through the pickaxes and stuff like that. This whole area is just humongous. You can see everywhere on the map where I've put torches, fire the light, and I've got a lot of stuff, shall we say. So let's open the inventory quickly, and you can see what we've got. A lot of iron. It's getting to the point where I may not pick up the iron, because why do I need 400 pieces of iron? But we've got 57 biofossils, we've got a little bit more diamond, we've got 5 frozen meats, we've got tons of plant fossils and relic scraps. We also have a mammoth rib cage, a little bit of diamond, and one of, yes, the quagga tooth, and a little bit more obsidian as well. Now, I also made a sword, because we need a sword, but I am playing on peaceful right now, because it was hell otherwise. So, how do I get down? There's a way down. I don't know. Oh, it's down here. I knew I'd built a way down, but I couldn't quite remember where. Yeah, this area. Oh, hello. Meh. I can leave the iron, but I can't leave the fossil. Ah. Oh, the ice stone. I have to use a diamond pick. I don't have a normal pickaxe anymore. I've used it all up. We need it. Also, I want to talk to you guys about ink. We need ink, okay? Part of the big plan for the series revolves around ink. And unfortunately, I can't find a squid. I've travelled. If you look on the map, this is all this ocean here is where I've travelled. I can't find a squid. I just can't find a squid anywhere. They just don't seem to exist. And I've checked the mods and none of them are disabling the squids. So where they've gone, I have no... Oh, screw it. Let's grab it. Where they've gone, I have absolutely no idea. So I want to spawn in some ink, okay? I'm asking you guys whether I can do that or not. It's up to you completely. If not, we will find a way to get ink. We will find a way to make the books we need without doing it. But I would like to make the big books and like put loads of details in and get our like bookcase going and all that kind of stuff. And I think we need to... Oh, this is risky, but oh, I've got more. There we go. Yeah, I've kind of... You'll notice as we go through the mines, I've kind of... oh, hello, Cheeky. Bit of gold. There's torches everywhere, and I've also killed all the water at all available opportunities because water's a pain in the ass, and also blocked in a lot of the lava, although I think this is a dead end to this. I've spent so long in here. We're gonna leave, we're gonna go home. Boop. Like so. Lovely stuff. I'm gonna put away the... Nope, I have no inventory space. Let's go to the lab. And today we're gonna have a fairly chill episode today. Oh, also, if you look out into the garden... You should be able to see. Yeah, there they. Hey, look at that. He's a big boy now. It's a lot easier to find them. I know the second one's in there. I think the second one's in there. I'm sure the second one's in there somewhere. I'm 90% sure. I can only see one. But he's a big boy. Where the hell is the other? Where are any of my other dinosaurs at this point in time? Not a bloody clue. Right, on we go. Yeah, we already had like 30-something, 39, I believe, biofossils, so we've got a good... Where are we? We've got nearly 100 biofossils ready to get going here. We are going to get ourselves a whole load of dinosaurs. So, let's open this chest. Let's put it all away for now, so we can keep up to date. Right, let's grab that back out. And... 35 biofossils. Yeah, there we go. Why are you stacking? That's really weird. Meh. One of them, whatever. Right, organize. Anything else that needs to go in there? Yes, the ferns, and we are good. Into big chest. Oh, so much iron, so much iron. I did put a stack in over here in the furnace. So let's just keep doing that. Let's get burning through this. We have incredible amounts of stuff. We should make a whole new armor set as well, because we are... My constant desire to jump into the lava has, oddly enough, led to some problems with my armor. I know that's surprising. Let's make a new hat. New booties. Oh, I need to be careful about doing that. What was that that I just saw? Also, I've completely forgotten how to make absolutely everything else. Right, let's have a little look. Iron. And we want chestplate. Okay. There we go. And we also want leggings. Okay, cool. That makes a lot of sense, doesn't it? Boop. Got some lapis. Got loads more coal. We actually started to really run out of coal, so I started to focus in on that a little bit more. I've cleared this box up a little bit because we had just incredible amounts of trash. So I've got rid of a lot of the dirt and stuff like that, a lot of the gravel. Goat. Good job being goaty. Put that away, put that away. Put the diamond in the other box, put that in there. Could do with making another pickaxe. I don't know what we're going to do with this diamond. I think we want to make an enchanting table. We've got... Oh, that's not what goes. We've got a little bit of obsidian, which we need, I believe. And we've got diamond. I think we've got everything we need. Let's have a little cheeky little peek. Yeah, we could do that. We could actually make an enchantment table. Now, I don't really know how these work, if I'm being completely honest. So I'm going to hold off. I'm going to do a little bit of research before the next video. And then we'll come back and do that. Let's stick those in there. Oh, 64 is the max stack, isn't it? That's why it's not doing any more. Right? Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Bloody hell, I thought I was going crazy. Okay, cool. So, legs, hat, chest, booties, looking fine. I'll put that in the bin. That's analysing away, getting me some lovely sand, just what I wanted. Good stuff. Amazing. And we're going to nip to bed. Now, today we're going to start work on the Ceratosaurus. However, we're also... We're going to grab ourselves our... There it is. I was like, where the hell is my egg? We're going to put the Pachycephalosaurus in. I'm also thinking, temporarily at least, we might put the... Where's the Ankylosaurus? We might put the... Somebody suggested this. I thought it was a cool idea. We might put the Ankylosaurus in with Tempo. I think they'll fit together fairly well, and it'll give Tempo a friend. Saying that, we actually might put the Dryosaurus in instead. I don't know, that might look nicer, right? No, I think the Ankylosaurus is a good idea. Let's grab a bucket, which I have several thousand, apparently. Boop. Yeah, let's give him an Anky friend. And we can always move stuff at the end if absolutely... Oh, Allosaurus. Allosaurus. It's really good. Oddly enough, we're getting sand, right? Sand's rubbish, but sand is also very useful. We need a lot of glass for this kind of playthrough. Right, we're going to go to bed. I'm going to put those back over there because I hate that. I've burnt through so many torches. Oh my god, the amount of torches I've burnt through. Because I put down torches everywhere I go. Like, I know you can double fist them, like I just said. Double fisting is how you should do everything in life. But if you put down torches as you sort of walk around, you can kind of obviously see where you've been before. It's like a really good way of just sort of knowing you've explored that part of the cave. You can see I've done a lot of teleporting. It's the only thing I give myself. I'm still playing on survival mode, obviously. Clearly. But teleporting is useful, so all you do is open to LAN and you set it to cheats enabled, but you keep it on survival mode and that lets us teleport around as need be. Really just so I can get to the house and back. But, hey ho. Right, yes, Ceratosaurus today. Today is Ceratosaurus day. Very excited. Gonna have to kill some sheep. How are we doing? Parasaur, very cool, very cool, very cool. Nope, not cool though. Now, do we want to put the parasaur with the... No, we want cobblestone. I want a lot of cobblestone. I've got a little bit of a plan for the Ceratosaurus. We're going to try today, but I want all my cobblestone out. And I think we want iron. I'm thinking iron. Iron. Oh, enchanting iron. Iron. Fair. Man. Iron bars, that's what we're looking for. They don't... we're going to make some iron bars. We've got tons of iron, so I'm not really worried about it. Let's grab that. Everything's looking good. Nope. There we go. That should be enough. Temporarily, at least. That should be enough. We actually don't have that much iron here, but... We will do, because we've got... four and a half, nearly five stacks of the stuff, so yeah. One more little look, come on, last one. Right, let's go. Let's get to work, folks. This is probably going to be a double episode thing for the Ceratosaurus, and we'll put down our little babby Pachycephalosaurus along the way. I will be here for the birth of every new creature on this island. So we'll put down the Pachycephalosaurus, and then we'll talk quickly about what we're going to do with the Ceratos. Boop. How you doing, buddy? Again, that. Okay, so the plan for the Ceratosaurus, like I said, this is probably going to be the biggest exhibit we've done in terms of not necessarily size and... Oh, no, I know what I'm going to do. Oh, we're not doing Ceratosaurus. I forgot. I had a different plan. We're actually going to do Dilophosaurus. My bad. I've set up for the Dilophosaurus-ish. I actually had a big plan organized in my head about how we're going to do Dilophosaurus, and it does not involve iron bars at all, so I don't know why I've made all the iron bars. No, well, that's for the Ceratosaurus in the future. We're going to do Dilophosaurus today, because we've got two Dilophosauruses as well. We should go get those eggs ready, and then I'll show you what I'm planning for the Dilophosaurus, and then I want to go check on the Mosasaurus as well. It's been like 5 in-game days since we saw the Mosasaurus, so it should be getting nice and big. Whilst we're waiting, we're going to nip over here. We're going to put the Dilophosauruses in here. You can see I leveled all this area up. It's nicely regrown, thankfully, but we're going to put the Dilophosauruses down there. Now, I thought I'd blocked that off. We're going to need to go make some shovels, but we're going to block off the bottom. That's the bit with the water that comes down into the cave underneath. Now, I do still want to use that, but for now, we're just going to... For now, we're going to sort of leave that alone, and we'll try to think of a way to integrate that in the future. My problem with the Ceratosaurus and anything else other than the Dilophosaurus is I'm not really sure where I'm going to put stuff now. So, this is going to lead you to the Dilophosaurus. We can put something there, but probably not a dinosaur. And then we've got this kind of circle around the house, which is just filled with stuff and dinosaurs. You know, in terms of sheer space, we're kind of running out until we start to get further out. Now, we can probably start to work in this area on the way to the beach house. Maybe the Ceratosaurus could go here. That looks like quite a nice flat area there. But the idea for the Ceratosaurus is to do like a proper Jurassic Park style thing. So we're going to do like a cobblestone base, and then we're going to do some iron bars along the top. And then we're going to build like a viewing area, kind of like from Jurassic Park Operation Genesis. You know, one of those little tower things. You walk up and it's like this vent of glass or a gap, and you can look through to the Ceratosauruses. I think that's going to be pretty cool. So we're going to do Dilophosaurus this episode in there. Next episode, Ceratosaurus in probably there. We'll kind of maybe flatten that area a bit and make this, because it should be structurally sound. There's something over here ready for the beach, and I don't know, man. I don't know. I don't want to just put dinosaurs everywhere. We need things, you know? Things are cool. There you go. Right. Let's nip back into the hoose. Get our first dilo egg on the go, and then we will, It's a big boy! Get our first dilo egg on the go, and then we will, go and get that sorted. What was I hatching? I've kind of forgotten what I was hatching. Bloody hell, Tempo! Oh, nice. Oh my god, we can get triple Dilo. Very cool. Oh, it's an Ankylosaurus. Yeah, I forgot about that. Right, we might save that for a little bit. We've got 4 Brachiosauruses. That's kind of crazy. We should have 3 Dilophosauruses. Yes, very cool. I might make some more analyzers. I kind of want to speed up this process. But we'll see. Right. I don't know if this works, but that in theory should make 2 in a row, right? I think. I don't actually need all this cobblestone anymore. How are we doing? Tyrannosaurus, very cool, and an alligator gar. We're getting to the point where I don't need to worry about biofossils at all anymore. There's already a bloody enough biofossils, I think. It's getting a little crazy. You go in here. Sorry. You know what I'm like? I like my inventory to be nice and organized. I want to keep that piece of dirt. That's going in the bin. Right. I have a shovel. Is that enough shovel? Oh, we got another one there. Nice. That's probably enough shovel. Do we have enough shovel? Yeah, it's fine. One more. Let's wait for one more. How are we doing? And how are we doing? Yeah, you're already done as well, so let's grab a little bit more iron. Keep this iron train moving. I mean, I say that we're gonna like have too much, but I suspect at some point this will become a thing that we need loads and loads of iron. I don't even want dinosaurs. Dinosaurs are for nerds. Right, let's go check on the Mosa, and then we'll work on this Dilo exhibit. I said we're gonna take it fairly chill today, because my eyes are on fire for some reason. Floof. Hey, buddy. So, yeah, we still haven't named the dinosaurs. Like I said, I want to wait until we get the books going. Again, if you want to name, say, the Dilophosaurus from this episode, you can do so in the cutie down below in the description. Just load up the cutie and you'll be able to tag your comment with the Dilophosaurus and then tell me what name you want it to have. But until we get the book shelf going, until we get the library going, we can't really name them. I have finished this, by the way. Spinosaurus. It's now pointing the other way. And there's also demonic farm animals that have been spawned from the gate, apparently. But yeah, I managed to fill it up with lava just by going and getting out and kind of like grabbing lava from the nether. And yeah, pretty happy with it. I think it looks pretty cool. It's definitely not what I originally envisioned, to be totally honest with you, but the only... Hello. The only problem I have with it is it doesn't really link in over here. So, the plan is you're going to come forward, we're going to build like a viewing platform here, and then you'll look down into there, and the Dilophosaurus, I just think it looks like a really cool place for Dilophosaurus to live. It's got this kind of swampy, natural kind of feel to it. You know? And I just think it suits the Dilos really well. That, however, suits nothing and no one. That's dreadful. We're going to have to find a birch and fix that tree. Or just kill the tree. Nah, I like the tree, though. We have to find a birch tree. There's one over there. Let's go kill the birch. Go check on our Mosa. And then all we need to do is go into the Dilo exhibit. And for now, at least, knock down the sides of it. So the blocks are all at least 2 blocks tall. And that way we can guarantee that they won't escape. I say guarantee they won't escape. I never feel like there's ever a guarantee that nothing will escape in this game. What is going on? I was going to say this is Pig Hill as well, but every hill in this game is Pig Hill. Every single one of them. Look at that spine, that's awesome. Oh, God. I haven't been to the beach house in ages. Oh, I forgot. I'm on Let's go check in on the Mosa. Nope, I didn't want to do this. This was a bad idea. Like, I thought this was a swimming pool. This is not the swimming pool. This is the Mosasaurus exhibit. It's in there somewhere. Buddy? Oh, don't go in the water. Don't go in the water. This is a good opportunity to try out our... No, I can't show you the viewing area because I actually haven't been working on it. I kind of forgot, to be honest. Mosa? Oh, there he is. Oh! Oh, he's a big boy now. Yeah. That's a much, much bigger Mosasaurus than it was last time I was here. Jesus. Oh. Well, he's well fed, so he's leaving me alone. Oh, now I'm going to drown. I'm glad that he's getting big and strong. I do wish I could light it up a little bit better. I don't know if, like... The Spinosaurus just move. I don't know if, like, covering the bottom of the Mosa tank with glowstone or, like, you know, like a ring of glowstone around the bottom would make it, Look at the... It's so curious. What's this big red shiny stuff? Will it hurt? Yes, it will hurt a lot, my friend. Yeah, I don't know. If we cover the bottom with glowstone, will it, like... light it up enough that you can see the Mosa a little bit better. Or, since we don't have much glowstone, what we could do instead... That is beautiful for you to sleep to. What we could do instead is kind of dig 2 blocks down and put in like a torch and then put some glass over the torch, something like that. Although I imagine that's quite hard work. We'll see. Alright, back to work. Dilo egg time. Nedry's Killers will definitely not be the title of this video. I don't know what you're talking about. I would never do such a thing. The Animania mod is becoming an issue for me. It's just too much. They just breed uncontrollably. It's insane. I really want to see both Brachys. It's made me a little nervous. That's one. They're never at the feeder. It's very strange. Right. Shoveloot. Let's go down here. So this is where I'm going to live. So all we need to do, places like this, just kill it everywhere it's a single block, basically. Which is going to ruin the look a little bit, but hopefully not too much. If we just match the actual shape of the exhibit, it should have this... like it's like a little lost world kind of thing, you know, which seems appropriate to me. Is that... Oh, that's Anna, sorry. I think I saw some clay over there. There. That little grey bit looks like clay to me. Right, there we go. How the hell I get in and out of this exhibit? I have no idea right now. Didn't actually think about that. We're going to have to get like a little ladder, but imagine this like sort of grown over with grass again and a couple more trees maybe. And this is just a really cool looking little dialogue exhibit, I think. I think it's going to look great. Especially with three of them roaming around. Very cool. Let's undo this, won't we? We'll go make a ladder. As we... Meh! Go make a ladder. And then we need to... Like, I want to do like a platform viewing area here that maybe overhangs a little bit. Just like a wooden platform with a cobblestone outside of it. Kind of looks over this area. A way to look down. Because the humans should not go in the Dilophosaurus exhibit. That seems like a terrible idea, generally speaking. Unless they want to die. Suicidal humans are welcome to come to the park, you know? It's kind of like assisted suicide. But you get to be eaten by a dinosaur. Which, admittedly, is cool, but also sounds like a terrible, terrible way to die. I cannot imagine how immensely painful it is to be ripped apart by an animal like that. Ugh. Right, to the lab! I might set a teleporter in the lab. But, I don't know, it feels important that you have to run around at least a little bit, you know? There you go, buddy. Right, let's have a little look. How are we doing over here? Oh, Nautilus and Compsognathus. Is that our first compy? I think it is. How are we doing over here? Oh, only worked for one. I was hoping it'd sort of stack together, but it doesn't seem to be the case. Are you going? I think you are, but I can't really tell. I'm going to give you another bucket of milk just in case. I think it's going. It's lit up, isn't it? I don't know what's going on there. Okay. That's done. Tempo, be quiet, buddy. I'm going to give you a friend in a second. Right, get excited. We'll go put the Ikea in as well. Why not? Boop, boop. Look at this. This is crazy. We've got nearly everything. I wonder if there's anything we don't have. A lot of people want me to see the Terror Birds, but I have said we're going to wait just a little bit. We've only got Titaness for us. Didn't we get three of them? Am I going crazy? Huh. There's like four Terror Birds in the game, and I'd like to try to get all of them before we make the Terror Bird exhibit, but we can always build it and then go from there. So Terror Birds, the point is Terror Birds, Ceratosaurus, Dilophosaurus, those are the next three we're doing. But I also think we need something non- dinosaur based, because I think if you're just running between exhibits it looks a bit weird. So we can definitely build probably something normal in there. We can definitely build in this area down by the beach, but we maybe want that to be beach themed. I kind of want like a viewing area around here by the Mosasaurus anyway. If we can put something there though, we can then start to build over in these hills over here to the south, and like over here maybe into the forest region, and over here past the quarry, and over here to the right. It's going to be a big project, this. We're going to need like little homes, little villages, little quarries, little machines, just stuff that makes it feel like an actual world rather than a massive series of exhibits. What would you have in Jurassic Park? What do? They just tour exhibits. Little bunkers, like security bunkers and stuff like that at some point. Just stuff that gives it like a real world feel, you know? What did we just get? Oh, right, sweet. Ooh, do we want to put both Mosasauruses together? That is the question. Is this egg going alright? Yeah, there we go. Right, let's go put down the... Where's my Ankylosaurus? There it is. Tempo, gonna give you a buddy. Also eat some... Oh, we also need to make a feeder. Much to remember. Much... Oh! Get out. I'm gonna have to murder these, aren't I? Yeah. Not only did he eat the grass... Like, you're fine, because you're on your own, but the rams... The rams are multiplying. They must be taken care of. I'm honestly tempted to make a diamond sword. Just to bloody stop this nonsense. Although, if we fix the sword... If we fix one of the fossils and archaeology swords we can get, then we can get like a really cool sword that... like something's like lightning or something, doesn't it? If I remember correctly. We good? Nope. You! Right, let's tell you what, let's put the egg down first, that would make more sense. You! Come here! Come here! Come here! The problem is, they eat, not only does it look silly, but they eat all the grass and they ruin my aesthetic. Tempo, get out of the way. Oh, look at the... I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. You must die. Don't hide under my Triceratops. Cheeky little bugger. don't feel good about this. Also, that water's right. I need to put some water in there. Right, there we go. There it is. Bloody Nora. Okay, we're good. Tempo, I'm going to give you a friend. And then eventually, they'll all have names. Next episode. Right, it's up to you guys whether we get the ink or not. But I would love to do in the upper floor of the house, in that bit there, build like a library, have a herbivorous section and a Cenozoic section and a carnivorous dinosaur section, and have little books, and it's all the details and their names and their habits and their birth date and all this kind of stuff. I think that'd be really, really, really cool. And if we end up playing this game for a super long time, let's say we're here in a year and, you know, the series lasts a whole year, we could have birthdays for our dinosaurs. We could have birthday parties for our dinosaurs on the right days and stuff like that. I don't know. It just gives you options. I just think it'd be really cool to write down these journal articles. And we can keep a diary as well of each day, like, that's happened since we got to, like, since we landed in this world. I just like telling, like, little stories with playthroughs. I don't know. But it depends if we can get the ink. Can you write in normal books? I don't think you can, right? You need a book and quill, which we need ink for. And a feather, but we have a feather, that's fine. We've got at least one feather on our way. What's the one I'm on about? So we can do that with just ink, but I want a big book. Because I believe the big books let you... I actually don't know what big books do. But I believe they let you do, like... you know what I mean? That's what they let you do. No, they let you do sort of formatting and stuff like that. I don't know. I think they just let you write it fancier. But I'll do a little research before next episode. So what have I got to do? I've got to research that, and I've got to research something else that I've entirely forgotten. Anyway, it's Ankylosaurus time. Oh. Hello, buddy. Aren't you adorable? Yes, you are. You and Tempo are going to get along great. You male or female? Let's find out. Female. Actually, what is Tempo? Male. Okay. You can have very awkward babies. Okay. Well, I'm going to check on our next dialogue, and then we'll head to bed. And then... let's see what we're doing tomorrow. Awesome. It's all working out. Come on, last one, baby. Last one. Be good to me. Be good to Papa. Oh, it's already... oh, because we already had... okay, whatever. Oh my god. Dinosaurs everywhere! right. Now I regret putting the Ankylosaurus in when we could have put another... look at this! Look how many dinosaurs we have! Two more Stegos as well. I kind of regret putting it in now. We could have put in... No. What we can always do is move the Ankylosaurus to a different exhibit at some point in the future. It's like a proper zoo would do that. You move things around depending on need, you know? But it's kind of sad. Like, I don't want to give Tempo a friend and then remove it. But we would give it a Triceratops friend, so maybe he'd be okay with that. I don't know. I'll have to ask him. Okay. Last dialo on the way. We are going to nip to bed. And then tomorrow we will go put our 3 Dilophosaurus eggs down. Very cool. This will be our most of any one species in the entire park. Gonna keep that door shut. The good thing is, like I say, like as we expand out, you can see how lit up it is. There's still dark spots where things can definitely spawn, but I haven't seen anything yet. I'm on easy, right? Yeah, weird. I just want to see a zombie. It will reassure me if I see a zombie. Bum, bum, bum. I love that. Oh, what's that there? There we go. There's a skeleton next to my skeleton. Awesome. Yeah, this is definitely going to be the library. We might actually make this into a stone wall, because I think having the library books stacked up against it might look a bit weird, but we'll put our books in there, we'll put our enchantment table in there. Oh, that's why I want to research enchantments. Yeah, that was the plan. I'm a little worried about this exhibit. Oh, there they go. Oh, it's so cool. So cool. Right. Is this a quick way down or a slow way down? I'm pretty sure this is a slow way down. Definitely slow way down. What I need is like a water slide that gets you down the house from upstairs. I want a water slide in my house. And the aquarium. We want to do an aquarium down here. As in, this wall here will all be an aquarium. And then it'll go up to the top. So as you're walking around up there, you'll be able to look down into this massive aquarium. And as we walk over to the lab, you'll be able to see the massive aquarium. Okay, so aquarium, Ceratosaurus, maybe like a security bunker, Dilophosaurus today, and Terror Birds. No! God damn it. How frustrating. Velociraptor. Right, here we go. Our first frozen meat as well. Okay, we need to make another cultivator. How do we do that? Glass, iron, bucket, We need one piece of iron, we need four pieces of glass, and we need a piece of cactus green. I am slowly starting to run out of cactus green. Because we haven't really gained any more cactus green, and we keep using it. Kind of thing. Where the hell's cactus green? It's there somewhere. Ah, there it is. Yeah, we've only got four left. Every time we burn through it like this, it's kind of an issue. Right, let me see if I can remember this. Probably not. Oh, we need to try and mess around with this bench a bit as well. Right. Nice. Right, let's try that again, shall we? This time. Okay. Yeah, Velociraptor's new one, and two Megaloraptors. Megalograptus, I should say, with a harder G in there. Still very cool. Oh, this is done. Right. Any bets on what we're going to get? I'm hoping for something cool. It's a mammoth! A mammoth! Now, we did already get... Actually, I forgot about this. We got a mammoth ribcage there, so we may get two mammoths. I'm going to stop calling them mammoths, but they are mammoths. Let's put those in there, and let's put that in there. See what else we can get out of all of this. But a mammoth would be pretty cool. I'd be very on board with the mammoth. Right, you are done, I believe. Yes. Let's grab... We're going to burn through all the iron first. Sure. Yeah. Oh, a quagga? We definitely need to set up the barn at some point as well. Come on, mammoth. Hey, there we go. Good stuff. That's not guaranteed. We've seen in the past that you can definitely get not dino DNA or prehistoric creature DNA from the... oh, nice. Oh, quaggas for days. Good old Phaelosaurus. Okay. It's getting a little overboard at this point. I kind of want to do like an Ice Age sort of zone kind of thing, you know, with the quaggas, the elasmotheriums, the mammoths. We could do like a whole... I mean, the Smilodons already have the little area. We could do like a Cenozoic... bit, like you walk through and the how are we gonna get snow? I don't think there's any snow anywhere near me. Well, I mean, we could go over there. It's a bit of a trek though. We could set up like a little Arctic base over here in the southwest and start developing. It'd be nice to kind of develop in two separate areas. We can always teleport between them really easily, right? There's a teleporter set at the house. We set one over there and just go pew 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 pew, and we had like an Arctic base over here, and then start to build like our mammoth exhibit and our... I don't know about the quaggas, probably not the quaggas, but we could build our mammoth exhibit over here and stuff like that. That'd be really cool. And then, pew, and like, you know, this area here looks really nice and flat, actually, so we could put some dinosaurs in this bit, or like quaggas there. I don't know, there's options. There's always options. That's what matters. How are we doing? Yeah, we're just going to wait on this egg, and then we're going to go... You can't stack them, can you? No. We're going to go put them all down, have ourselves some lovely dinos, and we will be done for today. And then next episode, we'll build up the dialogues a little bit more, maybe work on something else if I can come up with any ideas. And then Ceratosaurus, Terror Birds, Mammoths. There's too much to do. And like, I still want non-dinosaur stuff, and I haven't been working on this. You can see it's not moved at all, the glass tunnel. I just haven't been able to bring myself to... Oh, the effort involved in building this thing is killing me. I don't even know what I'm doing with it. Like, I think we're going to do like a line across here of glass, and then this will be an exhibit as well. And then maybe block this off and that'll be an exhibit. It's not a bad idea. So I've got all these, this little series of different... And then I kind of want the tunnel to go through the whole thing. You could have the tunnel go through the glass wall, right? So you walk through multiple exhibits through the glass tunnel. We could do that. Again, that's going to take hard work, but... Everything bloody takes hard work in this game. Come on, beautiful. Come on. Let's go check on our Anki whilst we wait. Tempo, have you been good to our friend? Tempo, yeah, I know, buddy, I know. Tempo, what have you done with the Ankylosaurus? Okay, I'm a little worried. I think I can hear it, though. So where the hell did the snake just go? Wasn't that... Oh, it's there. Ow. Right, there we go. There it is. Oh, you're so bloody tiny. No wonder I can't ever see you. Okay. You're alive. That's what matters. I was a little bit spooked there, but we're all good. Let's get some food down us because we're nearly dead. Oh, bloody Nora. Right. It's still glowing, which is a bad sign. Where do my eggs go? Is it in here? Yeah. We can do like a little snake thing as well. There's just so much stuff I want to do, you know? Very, very, very close. Show recipe. Oh my god. Oh, right, okay. It's not. What is that? That was a cow. Oh, is that a cow? Hey, beautiful. Right. 3 Dilophosauruses. Let's go put those down. Oh, no. We need to make a feeder. Whoopsie daisy. We also need to actually give them some bloody food. There you go. Pork chops, that'll do. How do I make a feeder again? No. Well, feeder does not have a sign that it's not a feeder. We need 4 pieces of stone. We need a button. Okay. Do we have... I always say, do we have stone? And we always have stone. That, we need that. Do we need glass? Yeah. We need a bucket. And we need 2 pieces of iron. Which also seems to have... That's still going. Bucket. Bomb. Right. Not bad. Best in the slot has a memory. It functions for about 2 minutes at best, but it is there. Undeniably, it does exist. Undeniably at this point. Right. Dilophosaurus time. Really should have bought my ladder. I don't know. So, like I said, I think... So the cobblestone's going to come out from here. You're going to walk forward. You're going to go up like a little staircase onto like a big wooden platform where you look down. And we might like put some like vines on it and stuff. And maybe make it out of... What's the cobblestone called? Oh, it's got like... Where's the cobblestone with the moss on it, but it's not chisel? Is it only chisel thing? No, moss stone. How do you get moss stone? We need vines. How do you get vines? I actually haven't seen vines, but I'd love to do it out of like... Yeah, that'd be really cool. But we'll probably just make it out of wood and cobblestone, and you'll look down over here, and you'll look down into the Dilophosaurus' faces. Right. Pew! Torch in the middle. Lovely stuff. No way out, right? I'm not going crazy. Might have to do like a little sweep whilst we're waiting for them to be born. Let's give them a feeder. Of course, we're going to want to come back and put in some more trees and put down some bone meal and stuff like that, but we'll get there. Yeah, I'm quite excited about this. I'm going to do a quick little sweep, make sure they can't get out, like using the trees or something like that. Doesn't look like it. That's beautiful. Look at that. Nope. I'm going to put some trees over here, particularly. I'm very nervous, but I think I'm good. Also, I need to check this. I did already fill this in a little bit with the... Thankfully, it's turned to grass, as you can see. But is that clay? That is clay. Below here is that craziness. And we will use the craziness. I just really don't know what for. We could even make it a double exhibit. So, you'd have the Dilophosaurus up here. And then you'd have a way from the viewing platform to actually drop down. And you'd look into the bit below the loft. It's kind of like with the Therizinosaurus and the Smilodons. But you'd have it as like a double viewing area. So it's like this big glass wall. You look into the Dilo exhibit and you drop down a floor. And the glass carries on. And you look down into an exhibit or something else that lives there with the waterfall at the bottom. I don't know. Just an idea. How are we doing? We're getting there. I don't want it to be nighttime. I want it to be the middle of the day. Wait. Oh yeah, can't you? Cool. I just don't want to see the Dilophosaurus hatch in the middle of the night, basically. But yeah, right, we are very nearly done, so let me know in the comments down below what do you think we should do next. If any of you have any ideas for non-dinosaur based stuff, I'd really appreciate that, because this is the main problem I'm having, is it's just dinosaurs everywhere, which is obviously kind of the point of the series, but I keep saying this, that we need non-dinosaur stuff to break it all up, you know, and I do really think that's the case. I really like it so far, I think it's really good so far, but it just needs... There they go. It just needs something to... I don't know. I like this idea a lot. We may start working on that soon. I really like the idea of having mammoths, you know? Boop! 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 Oh no! No! Oh, come on! Buddy, I'm so sorry. I tried. Where's the other one gone? Oh, that sucks. That's really, really unfortunate. I don't really know what to say about that. That sucks. That super sucks. I'm really annoyed now. The egg was nowhere near the wall, and it just jumped into it at birth, which is stupid. Dilo, I need a thumbnail. Can you come here, please? Dilo. Water's messing with me. Well, there's our Dilophosaurus. Slightly disastrous, I will say, but I don't know. Can we spawn in another egg, or do you want me to not spawn in another egg? Because I mean, it was kind of my fault. I probably could have prevented it with better egg placement. So if we just have to take the loss and not get the Dilos, then I will accept that. I give it over to you, my judge and jury. Anyways, yes, we're going to end there. So let me know in the comments down below what you think we should do with the... what do we do next? Do we do the mammoth? Do we do the Ceratosaurus? Do we do the pterobirds somewhere? Do we do the... Well, we need to do more of the Dilophosaurus. We're going to do that next episode as well. Yeah, just let me know what you think. I've asked many questions. And what do we do for the Dilophosaurus? What do we do with the enchanting table? Do I spawn in the ink? You've got like 25 things to answer in the comment section, so get to work, folks. Thanks for joining me. Cheers. Much love, as always. Please do hit the like button if you enjoyed this video and this series. It really helps me out. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.